हेलो, एवरीवन इज देयर? कैन आई एम ऑडिबल?
यस मैम,
तो लिक्विड,
हाउ कैन यू डिफाइन लिक्विड?
लिक्विड्स इज
लिक्विड्स
बेसिकली,
आर लूजली पैक्ड एंड कैन इजीली गेन एनी शेप और साइज.
हाँ, इट कैन, इट इज लूजली पैक्ड and can gain any shape of the container. Okay? So they have weak forces as compared to the solids. Fine. And they do not have any rigid structure. They are flowable. They have flow properties. Even gases have flow properties. So the space occupied is equal to the shape of the container. Gases, whatever the spaces are is available in the air, gases occupy the whole space. If you are enclosing it in a container, it will occupy the whole space. Okay, but liquids are confined to much more. Okay, so solid, liquid, and gases, the states of matter changes with respect to temperature and pressure. Okay, what will happen? Solid air, if you increase the temperature, what will happen? They will gain kinetic energy, the bonds will break, and what will happen? Weak bonding will be now prevailing because of the weak bonds. That is due to the kinetic energy and movement of the molecules, the bonds break and it gets converted into liquid. That is when you increase the temperature. The solid is getting converted to liquid. Next, liquid, when you further increase the temperature, what will happen? The liquids will again go apart and they will be converted into gases. That is the forces or the distance between the molecules will still increase when you increase the temperature. So solid, liquid and gases. When you increase the temperature, the states of matter changes. The same thing is with the pressure. When you apply pressure, what will happen on the gas? So gas, when you apply pressure, what will happen? It will get converted into liquid. Okay, that is when you apply pressure, the molecules will come closer. So it will get converted into liquid. And again, if you apply more pressure, much more pressure, it will get converted into a solid. So these three states of matter exist depending on the temperature and pressure. That is the outside parameters, that is depends on the temperature and pressure. Okay? So these are the states of matter. We will be starting with the binding forces. So as I've said, intramolecular forces and intermolecular forces. Intramolecular, as you can see, it is between the same molecules of the same compound. And intermolecular, these are two compounds. These are two compounds, one and two. And the intermolecular forces exist between the molecules of the two compounds. Now, these forces are of two types. One are attractive forces and the other one is the repulsive forces. Attractive forces, that is because of which the molecules come closer together. Repulsive forces, the molecules goes apart, or they are, you can say, they move apart because of the forces of repulsion. So these are the two important forces, attractive forces and repulsive forces, which dominate on the molecule. Okay, so what are the various types of attractive forces and what are the various types of repulsive forces? So we are going to study the forces of attraction, binding forces of attraction, that is the attractive force. Now here you can see a diagram. Okay, now what is this diagram or this chart represent? It is basically a plot of potential total energy content, okay, in a given compound. It is a plot of energy. On y-axis we can see is the plot of energy versus the interatomic distances. Okay, that is interatomic distance means the distance between the two atoms, or that you can say intermolecular distance, the distance between the two molecules. Okay, so in this graph we can see here the molecules are too close together, and when the molecules are too close together, what will happen? What is happening? The repulsive forces are predominating. Okay, that is the forces of repulsion predominate. Why these forces of repulsion is predominating when the molecules are too close together? It is because of the electronic cloud. Atom is made up of what? It contains protons and neutrons, that is nucleus, and surrounding is the electrons revolving. Okay, so there is a negative electronic cloud. Okay, so because of this electronic cloud, what is happening? The two forces of matter, these are the molecules or the atoms are repelling each other because of the electronic cloud. This is a negative and this is also a negative. So when negative negative comes together, it repels. So at very small distances, interatomic distances, the forces of repulsion is predominating. Now here, as the energy is decreased, that is the total energy is decreasing, or when the distance between the two molecules is an optimal, okay, at a certain distance, the molecule forces of attraction predominates. Okay, at this small intermolecular distance, the forces of attraction is predominating. Okay, why forces of attraction is predominating? Because the two molecules, that is the two ions, if these are counter ions or opposite ions, one is negative charge and other one is positive charge. So the positively charged nucleus tries to attract the negative electronic cloud. So at certain distance, that is the optimal distance, the molecules forces of attraction predominate. And at two large distances, interatomic distances, there is no attraction or no repulsion. That is at this point. Okay. So first here, at very small distances or short distances, the forces of repulsion predominates. At finite or medium distances, forces of attraction predominate. And at very large distances, interatomic distances, there is no attraction or no repulsion between the molecules. This is a plot of energy, that is the potential energy versus the interatomic distance. Okay. When forces of attraction predominate, the energy in the system is at its minimum. Okay. That is when forces of attraction predominate, the energy of the system is at its minimum. I will give you the range at which these forces of attraction is predominating. It is 4 × 10⁻⁸ cm. 4 × 3 or 4 × 10⁻⁸ cm. This is the optimal distances at which the intermolecular forces of attraction is predominating. Next, we are going to study what are the various forces of interaction. I think so very less time is available with us, 5 minutes. We have started at 9:15, correct? So the various intermolecules of attraction which are prevailing are van der Waals forces, hydrogen bonding, ion-ion interaction, and ion-dipole interaction. So these are the various forces of interaction. Okay, we are studying the states of matter. In states of matter, there are 3 states of matter. The 4th has been discovered. Now, states of matter. Matter is made up of what? Atoms, molecules, or ions. Okay. So, what are the binding forces of? What are the various forces which are prevalent? One is repulsive forces, and the other one is attractive forces. Force of attraction and force of repulsion. I have explained you how the distance plays a role in the forces of attraction or repulsion. When forces of repulsion predominate and when force of attraction predominate. Okay? We are going to study the various forces of attraction. Repulsion are due to the electronic cloud at a very minute distance. So various forces of interaction are van der Waals forces, hydrogen bonding, ion-ion interactions, and ion-dipole interactions. What are van der Waals forces? What do we mean by van der Waals forces? Can anyone tell? Have you studied van der Waals forces? What is a dipole? What do you mean by dipole? What is a polar molecule and what is a non-polar molecule? Anyone? Are you listening or sleeping? Wake up. You are in the college. Hello? Anyone? What is a dipole? Ajay, Kang. Dinar? Dinar? Qureshi? Can you tell me what is a dipole? I means two, pole means pole. South pole, north pole, or you can say negative and positive. Polar and non-polar molecules. What is a polar molecule? What is polar molecule? Here you can see the picture of or a molecule of water, that is HOH, with H2O. Okay. H2O is consisting of two atoms. One is oxygen, the other one is hydrogen. Okay. Now here, hydrogen is less electronegative as compared to oxygen. And what happens because of this? Oxygen being more electronegative, it tries to attract the electrons from the or hydrogen. Okay. So being electronegative, it tries to attract the electrons from the hydrogen. And therefore, it develops, the molecule develops a charge, slightly negative charge and slightly positive charge. Okay. So these partial charges which are occurring here, hydrogen develops partial positive charge, oxygen develops partial negative charge, because more electrons are towards oxygen and less towards the hydrogen. Now the molecule becomes polar, that is partial negative, delta negative and delta positive charge is been prevailing. So this molecule is known as the polar molecule, which is having positive as well as negative. So H2O is a very good example of a polar molecule. Water is a polar solvent. Okay, the very basic solvent in which all the soluble drugs go. Okay, so water is a polar solvent. So polar molecule, that is H2O, partial negative and partial positive charge. Okay, so dipole means which is having partial negative and partial positive charge.